Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about use memo hook, which is another popular and it is kind of similar which we will be discussing as use callback. Okay, before going there we will just talk about the use reference one more example. Here you can see I have input text field. I provided an input reference. So what all things you can do in terms of accessing DOM and changing it. So this reference input you have provided, now you can actually access the current from it. We were doing it reference.current.focus, right? So I got the access to current. Now I can just add the class lit, access the class list, add event listener, remove event listener. Whatever you can do in terms of DOM manipulations like binding an event, removing an event, adding a class list, removing a class list, all these things you can do on this, on particular event. So this is what we have in use effect. Whenever the component is unmounting, we are actually removing these listeners, focus and blur. But whenever you are doing a focus and blur on this input text field, we have already added these events. On focus, handle focus is getting triggered, which is just adding active class. And on the blur, it is actually removing that active class. So this is one of the good example of how we are using use effect and use reference together. We got the reference, we got the current value of that reference. And now we are just playing around it by adding an event listener to that DOM node. This current is nothing but a DOM node, right? And you see this current here, we are able to add event listener. So whatever you can do a DOM node, all these things are possible onto this current, because current is nothing but a DOM node. Add event listener, remove event listener, add class list, class list dot add, class list dot remove. Okay. After this, talking about this use reference, now we are back with use memo hook, another important one. In the use memo, let me just go to this example and clean this up. Okay, so another example we are going to talk about is use memo hook. Okay, and what use memo hook is doing, whenever we are doing some heavy computational stuff in our React component, and we don't want it to do it every time whenever the component is getting rendered again, right? In that case, you can use this use memo hook, which will cache these heavy computations for us, and we don't need to get into a trouble where the state is getting changed and again lot of computation is happening. Okay, so this hook is very much similar to use callback. The difference is use callback returns a memonized callback and use memo returns a memonized value. So this memonized word is kind of familiar, right? What it means, it's storing some value in a cache. So use memo is storing some value in the cache, and whenever it is getting executed, it is checking, okay, did I already done with this heavy computation? Do I have the value? So it will directly return it. Okay, sometimes you have to actually compute the values either through a complex calculations or either through a database. So in that case, you can actually use this use memo hook to get the value. So it is something like this. So we are doing use memo. This is some function which is doing some calculation. That value you are getting directly here, right? This value you are actually calculating every times whenever the state is getting changed. In that case, you can use memo. It will actually memonized this value is returned from this extensive operation. Okay, there are many use cases of doing it. First of all, why we need a memonization? So before understanding that, we have to understand few JavaScript aspects about the referential integrity, like referential equality in JavaScript. And we already know that how we are using use effect. Okay, I will just tell you one example that what is happening with this code. So here we actually provided an object. Okay, and we are actually doing some stuff from here. Right now, if this object is not even getting changed, all the properties are same, but this use effect hook is actually running the referential equality, and it will always found that new object, this is a new object which is not equal to the previous object. How can you say this? In JavaScript, this comes out as a false. So use effect will trigger if the previous value is not equal to the new value. In this case, this use effect will trigger, and consider that you are doing some heavy computation here, and every time without this object property change, you're still executing these functions and a lot of calculation is happening. Okay, so this thing is false. Similarly, if you just returning a function, this function is returning an object, and there is another function, an arrow function, which is returning an object. And if you just try to do triple equals, that is also false. Okay, so this is the problem, right? In this particular case, this use effect is doing a referential equality and it is going to execute it even if it is getting same property in an object. Okay, so how can we get rid of this? That is another concept, is memonization. You may have heard of this fancy word. This memonization is basically an optimization techniques which passes a complex function to be memonized or remembered in the cache. Now, if that memonized stuff is a callback function, then we will be using use callback. But if that is a simple value, then we will be using use memo hook. Okay, something like this. Here we have use memo we are using, and this is some computation is happening. We are getting AB and returning this. Okay, so use memo example can be a simple one. What we are doing is like use state, use effect. Similarly, we are using use memo, right? Use memo is something, if we just talk about the simple example, it can simply look like this. List of items. Okay, we are doing a map, and for every item, you see what we are doing is we are calculating a lot of things. We are doing a lot of extensive operation. Okay, so what change we are looking at? The list of items. Right, so in this above example, the use memo function would run on the first render. It would block the thread until the extensive operations are complete, and this use memo runs in the render. Initially, this won't look as clean as use effect, since use effect can render a loading spinner until you get all the data. However, the expensive function would never fire off again if list item never changed, and it will still return the same value. What I said is, if you see the difference, if I write it in the difference as a use effect, okay, let's compare it with a use effect. Here I have use effect, which is doing something like this. Okay, we already have arrow function, and it is dependent on this. Okay, if you compare both the things, what will is the difference here? Even if you are getting the same list of items, that is not equal to the previous list of items according to JavaScript, so it will execute again. For use memo, list of items are the same element, it will not compare that in terms of JavaScript. If those are same, it is never going to execute this set of code, which is heavy computation happening here. Right, so what it is doing, it is preventing the re-rendering thing, right? So we are just using use memo for that. Use effect cannot do that, so we can replace use effect wherever we see these kind of cases. We can just replace that use effect with use memo. So if you just talk about this example where we are using use effect, and we'll see what is happening here. Here we are getting these two in the props. So here, remember we were talking about referential equality, where even this array is different than this array. This is coming out as a false. Okay, we also talked about this object. When we are comparing this, this also coming out as a false. So for use effect is something is changed, right? So use effect hook watches the fish and insects here, which are the props being passed. Okay, but this is only works with the primitives. Okay, fish and insect, if there are primitives like boolean number, then that is fine. It will just check only if number is same, 1, 2, 3, boolean is true and false, that is fine. What if we convert this into an object, fish is an object, insect is an object, right? Then we will get into a trouble because this use effect hook will be getting executed even we are passing the same fish and same insect object from the props. Okay, so this is the problem, and how we can fix it? We can just, instead of use effect, we can use memo, and we are good. Okay, so this simple example of use memo is here. Okay. Yeah, so this example should be fine, and we can remove this. So this is a very basic example. Use memo is actually caching or memorizing the returned value when the list of items are being passed, which is some array of three values. Same values are coming back again, it will not trigger this. It already has the value, so it will return that. Okay, this is about use memo. Similarly, we have a use callback that is actually returning a callback function instead of this value. Memorized callback function instead of this value. Okay, thanks everyone.